Biography of No Psychologists. Wilhelm Wundt, German physiologist and psychologist. Wilhelm Wundt, born August 16, 1832, Neckarau, near Mannheim, Baden, Germany. Died August 31, 1920, Großbaden, Germany. German physiologist and psychologist who is generally acknowledged as the founder of experimental psychology. Wundt earned a medical degree at the University of Heidelberg in 1856. After studying briefly with Johannes Müller, he was appointed lecturer in physiology at the University of Heidelberg, where in 1858 he became an assistant to the physicist and physiologist Hermann von Helmholtz. It was during this period, in 1862, that Wundt offered the first course ever taught in scientific psychology. Until then, psychology had been regarded as a branch of philosophy and, hence, to be conducted primarily by rational analysis. Wundt instead stressed the use of experimental methods drawn from the natural sciences. His lectures on psychology were published as Vorlesungen über die Menschen und Thierseele, 1863, Lectures on the Mind of Humans and Animals. He was promoted to assistant professor of physiology in 1864. Bypassed in 1871 for the appointment to succeed Helmholtz, Wundt then applied himself to writing a work that came to be one of the most important in the history of psychology, Psychology, Principles of Physiological Psychology. The Grundzüge advanced a system of psychology that sought to investigate the immediate experiences of consciousness, including sensations, feelings, volitions, and ideas. It also contained the concept of apperception, or conscious perception. The methodology prescribed was introspection, or conscious examination of conscious experience. In 1874, Wundt went to the University of Zurich for a year before embarking on the most productive phase of his career, as professor at the University of Leipzig, 1875 to 1917. There, in 1879, he established the first psychological laboratory in the world, and 2 years later, he founded the first journal of psychology. Introspection, from Latin introspicere, to look within. The process of observing the operations of one's own mind with a view to discovering the laws that govern the mind. In a dualistic philosophy, which divides the natural world, matter, including the human body, from the contents of consciousness, introspection is the chief method of psychology. Thus, it was the method of primary importance to many philosophers, including Thomas Hobbes, John Locke, George Berkeley, David Hume, James Mill, John Stuart Mill, and Alexander Bain, as it was to the 19th century pioneers of experimental psychology, especially Wilhelm Wundt, Oswald Culp, and Edward Bradford Titchener. To all these men, the contents of consciousness appeared to be immediate experience. To have an experience was to know that one has it. In this sense, introspection appeared to be self-validating. It could not lie. Wundt and his disciple Titchener believed that introspection finds in consciousness a dynamic mixture of essentially sensory materials, which are sensations proper, images, and feelings that closely resemble sensations. Known as classical introspection, this view remained popular only as long as Titchener continued to expound it. Many other psychologists found different kinds of content in consciousness. The German philosopher Franz Brentano saw consciousness as constituted of both sensory contents and more impalpable acts. For further information, please see additional video links in the description box. Let you watch the video and get more information.